So Microsoft is a really popular way to be able to manage all of your projects and tasks. And there are lots of different task experiences inside of Microsoft tools. Today we have Matt from Collaboration Coach, who's actually going to explain the concepts behind task management in Microsoft products, which one might be most suitable for you, including tools like Microsoft To Do, Microsoft Planner, and Microsoft Lists, helping you to assign the best tool to your needs. A little bit diving into the task management inside of Microsoft. Please do make sure to check out Collaboration Coach here on YouTube. Matt has a fantastic channel, as well as Keep Productive here on YouTube as well. So here we go.
Hello, it's Matt, and I'm the host of Collaboration Coach. And thank you so much for having me back on Keep Productive. It's always a pleasure. So this time, I'm going to talk about Microsoft apps for managing tasks and which app you should use for the work you're doing. Microsoft has a dizzying array of options when it comes to keeping track of tasks. So I'm going to help you unravel some of the mystery around this subject. So today we're going to look at three apps: To Do, Planner, and Lists. They're all good at managing tasks in their own way, but you might use them in different scenarios. To Do is for personal task management, and anyone who has a Microsoft account can use it for free. It's a browser app, and there are also apps for Mac, Windows, iPad, iOS, and Android. Planner is optimized for managing your team or project tasks, and it would normally be used by a project manager or a team leader. It also has a browser app, and there are apps for iPadOS, iOS, and Android. But you can only use Planner if you have an Office or Microsoft 365 subscription. And lastly, Lists have been a part of Office 365 since it began, but Microsoft have recently rebranded it, added some sweet new features, and relaunched it as an app. So there's a browser app, and you can now get an app for Teams and your iPhone. And it's for anyone to use as long as they have an Office 365 or Microsoft 365 subscription. First, let's look at Microsoft To Do in more detail. To Do is very simple. You can create tasks and then you add them to task lists. You can choose the things you're going to do each day and add them to My Day. And My Day is just a list of the things you're going to do that day, and it clears down every morning ready for a new set of tasks. You close tasks when they're complete and they're removed from the lists, and you can also schedule tasks and flag them as important, and that will add them to the planned and important lists. You can create your own list for anything personal you're working on, and in the same way, you can add them to My Day when you're ready to do them. One of the benefits of using an Office 365 account is integration with Outlook and Planner. When you do that, you'll also see any emails that you flagged in Outlook. They show up in this flagged email list. Flagged emails are just emails that are turned into tasks. You can move them to other lists, you can schedule them, and you can add them to My Day. You'll also see any tasks that you've been assigned to with Microsoft Planner. These can be from different plans across all the projects and teams that you're involved with. Those tasks show up in the Assigned to You list, and you can add them to My Day as well. So to summarize then, the To Do app is the best place you can go to manage all of your personal tasks. And anyone who has a Microsoft account can use it for free on desktop or mobile. But if you have an Office 365 subscription, the integration with Outlook and Planner makes sure you can see your tasks wherever they come from. Thanks for watching so far. And if you want more videos like these, then please check out my YouTube channel, Collaboration Coach. We specialize in Microsoft 365 news, reviews, and tutorials, so make sure you check us out. Next, let's look at Planner. In Planner, you create tasks as cards, and then you add them to boards, so it's very similar to apps like Trello. Each task can have a start and a due date, it can have people assigned to it, and you can add notes and attachments. Planner tasks are organized into buckets, and these are the columns that you can see here. You can drag the task between the buckets, you can have lots of buckets in your plan, and you can create new ones. You can group your tasks together to get different views of them. For example, you could group by bucket, or you could group by the person they're assigned to, or even the due date. You can also filter the tasks. You could filter the whole plan to see which tasks are due this week. And there are charts to see your progress and scheduled views to see when tasks are scheduled for. It uses Microsoft 365 Groups for permissions, so it's available to you and everyone in your work group. And as we've seen, Planner integrates with To-Do. When you assign a task to someone, it will show up in their To-Do list as we saw earlier. To summarize then, Planner is for managing your team and project work. And you can have lots of plans and you can manage them all in the same place. The best experience is in the browser, but you can only use Planner if you have an Office or Microsoft 365 subscription. Now onto Microsoft Lists. Lists was not specifically built for managing tasks like To-Do and Planner were, but it can be used for that purpose and has some nice features to help it do that job. A list is essentially a way to store data in Office 365. It's just columns and rows, like an Excel spreadsheet in your browser. You can use lists to solve all sorts of problems, like tracking issues or managing assets. There are templates you can use to create lists, and one of them is called the Work Progress Tracker. So if I select this, I can create a task tracker that's all set up and ready to go. I can start adding my task and assigning people to them. Everyone in my work group can see these tasks, and I can set permissions on each individual task if I need to. The task list is completely customizable, which is one of the biggest benefits of using lists in this way. You can change the columns, you can remove them, and you can add new ones. And you can edit the tasks in a grid view, which makes the data appear in cells, like a spreadsheet, so you can do bulk edits if you need to. You can sort and filter the data, and you can save those changes into views. And you can create list rules that will apply workflows to your lists, so it will trigger actions when things change in the list. So to summarize then, Microsoft lists work best in the browser. They are probably the best fit for you if you need to be able to heavily customize what you're tracking. And it's basically for anybody to use as long as you have an Office or a Microsoft 365 subscription. So finally, a word about Teams. Microsoft have integrated To-Do, Planner, and Lists into Teams. There's an app called Tasks that you can add to Teams that gives you a view on your personal and Planner tasks in one app, all inside of Teams. And now there's an app for Lists as well. So this allows you to add your lists as channel tabs, so you don't have to open the browser and do all your work with your lists inside of Teams. So that's an overview of some of the task management apps in Office 365. I hope this was useful. Thank you so much for watching, and please check out our Collaboration Coach channel.